This take 18 times. You've missed your mark 3 times in a row. What is your problem, man?
It is you who are inept, sir, not me.
Glass. Cigarette.
You're not only talking to a horror star, but an eminent actor. I have played Julius Caesar on Broadway before you were born. I did Oscar Wilde and George Bernard Shaw on the London stage before you were a gleam in your daddy's eye. I will not get excited. My blood pressure pills.
Please spare us the heart attack, Conrad. I don't give a shit what you did 40 years ago. All I'm interested in is whether or not you can do a commercial today.
Why don't you get Orson Welles or Larry Olivier? Sir Lawrence to you.
I wish to God I had, because you certainly weren't my choice, Conrad. Oh, crap, let's take a break. Take 10 minutes. Take 20 minutes. What's the difference?
Stop.
Oh! to the mansion, Carl Joseph.
Of the City College Cinema Department and my students in the Film Society. Now, without further delay, allow me to introduce the man we've all been dying to meet, the last of the great giants of the horror cinema. It's my great honor to introduce Mr. Conrad Ragsoff.
Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, Professor Markowitz, I thank you from the bottom of my heart for inviting me. The honor of being here is entirely, entirely my own. You know, I thought the world had forgotten me a little. And I felt bitter and a little disappointed and sick at heart. I would like to say, I would like to.
Are you all right?
What happened?
We need you. Someone get some water.
Oh, my God.
Never died before. And I want to do it right. Go and get Wolfgang. Quick.
Conrad, my old friend.
Stop acting. Do your job as a director. Is everything ready?
Yes, everything.
You better do a good job, or you're fired. Especially the funeral. I want it to be magnificent. It's my last performance. And I want an Oscar. Do you understand? I want to die.
like a star.
Conrad! Conrad! Dead? Really? Dead? Yes, Conrad. I will direct your funeral.
Your last performance, just as I directed all the others.
You always said the red carnation is your signature. There. Perfect. You are dressed for your greatest role, death. All my life I wanted to tell you of. Now I can. The world is at last rid of you, and I am rid of you too. In pace requiescat. When I found you, you were nothing but a second-rate waiter. I gave you your first part, and your last. You made millions, and I got dreck. But without me, you would be nothing! Good night, sweet Prince of Ham. Go to hell. Go straight to hell.
thank you, my friends, for coming to my funeral. I'm appearing before you today in a pre-recorded tape, one of many I did before my untimely demise. You see, I didn't want anyone but me to star at my own funeral. Afterwards, please be my guests back at the mansion. Eat your fill of caviar and enjoy a cool glass of champagne. Ladies and gentlemen, a toast to me. I hope you won't find the mausoleum in bad taste. The board of cemetery directors objected at first, but then they decided I was a tourist attraction. You see, a star in life is a star in death. Remember, every time you see one of my films on TV, you're not only watching me, but I am watching you.
Bravo.
It was a moving funeral. It was downright unforgettable. Hundreds of mourners, flowers filling the chapel. Conrad gave his own farewell sermon from a TV screen. Conrad's widow, Etta Ratzoff, obviously shaken, pushing away the curious, those who came for a last glimpse of this great actor. As the funeral procession left the chapel and headed toward the great mausoleum. The mausoleum, something else, had loomed above the other gravestones. 100 feet long, solid granite, neon star twinkling with the name Ratzoff.
What are you up to, man?
Yeah. You stone are just getting weird on us.
Let's find out.
You know, the whole funeral was just like another scene in one of his flicks. I mean, I could see him get up in those supreme deluxe tails of his and just go wandering around the streets of Hollywood looking to suck some blood. I'll find around here a lot of tacky hookers.
He lives. He stalks. He sucks.
Listen. Listen to the wolves. They are the children of the night. Their voices are like music to my ear.
Hey. Let's go visit him.
Tell me you're kidding.
Stu, get the flashlights. Be a way to get in here.
Come on. Here I am.
You sure you want to do this? You guys serious?
Come on,
man. Here we go.
Ready. Ready.
Right.
One, two.
He said he was coming back from the dead.
Get sucked in by all that supernatural bullshit. I mean, his whole life was a
B-movie.
What's that?
What?
Wake me up when it's over.
Is that it, Steve?
Yeah, I think so.
Come on, Oscar.
Come on.
Lot.
What?
Lot.
Great. Wait a second. No, no. Hey.
Huh?
The roof.
Do it.
You got it?
Go.
You got it?
Go.
Go for it. Hey, Stu. Guys, there's a skylight up here.
Can you get in?
Well, I think so. I'll try.
Okay, do it.
All right.
Come on.
Bid you welcome to the castle, Rags Off.
Yeah.
Yeah. Come on. Oh, jump. Oh, my God.
Welcome. Good evening. This is Conrad Ragtsov coming to you from the dead.
Yes.
How kind of you to visit my crypt. I hope you are staying 1,000 years. If you have broken in, you probably will. For at the end of the message, the door to the tomb will slam shut forever.
Get the door now!
Let me conclude. Remember, I who am here was once like you. And you who are there will one day be like me.
What are you doing?
How do you open this thing?
Sweet.
I got it.
Oh, man. Look at that. He's got his tails and his cape on just like Bela Lugosi.
Yeah. Everything except breath.
Look at his eyes. They're still open.
They're not seeing shit.
Good evening, sir. I enjoyed your last performance very, 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 very much.
Let's stop that.
So, what do we do now?
Why don't we invite him home for dinner?
Why are we doing this?
Well, man, it's simple. I mean,
I mean, we love Conrad, right?
Yeah.
And Errol Flynn did it to John Barrymore.
Right? I bet.
Yes. And listen, it's very simple. I mean, the plan is we're just going to keep him here, right, tonight, and take him back in the morning, right?
Right, right.
Right.
What a banquet. What a meal.
Conrad, you've filmed here more than once. You probably know this place like the back of your hand. What can I say? Welcome home.
Oh, and long life.
Speech. Speech.
Speech.
Oh, yes. Speech. Speech. Speech.
Your silence is most eloquent, my lord.
Oh, come on, Meg. Where is your sense of humor, Pasadena?
Hey, that's my gal you're talking to.
I just don't think it's funny.
Oh, come on, Meg.
You know, I can hardly believe that's Conrad over there.
It's pretty weird.
Conrad, I always wanted to be your bride. Once, I stole a ring from my mother, and I secretly married you. On our wedding night, we made love in your coffin. Oh, it was beautiful.
Call it a wrap. It has been
night to remember.
Oh.
Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good night, Conrad.
Any sign of cult activity? Like black candles, red drapings, even incense ashes?
Not so far, sir, no.
And there's no ransom notes of any kind.
What do they want with his body? What should I do, Mrs. Rumor? Tell me, what should I do?
Don't ask me, Etta. Ask Conrad. You must ask him. Tell you. Do you really believe there is life after death? The soul lives after death. Why not the body?
How do we begin?
Get me some articles of his clothing. And then get me his pyramid.
Carl Joseph.
I'm trying to reach you, Conrad Ragsdoll. In the name of all holy and unholy spirits, listen. I'm trying to bridge the gulf between there and here, life and death. Where is your body?
Oh,
freaking out. He's dead as a fish.
Yeah, yeah. What was that noise?
I don't know. I don't believe the dead walk. I don't believe in life after death. The dead are dead. They don't walk and they don't scream.
Saint?
blew it for me. I was really getting into that. You're guilty of coitus interruptus. You know, I could suffer deep psychological damage. I could become a mental cripple for life.
Will you shut up? I'm trying to tell you I saw someone.
Look, Donna, it's 3 a.m. in the goddamn morning. Everybody's crashed. It's just a figment of your imagination. But I'll go check it out anyway.
Everywhere. Even in the attic.
Come on. There's nobody up there except Conrad. The attic's the one place I don't have to check. Look, if this is some kind of joke or something, I don't think it's funny. You're scaring the shit out of me.
Oh!
Oscar. Oscar?
Have this phone monitored 24 hours a day. And when she calls, we're gonna have our answer.
Oscar!
Donna!
I looked all over upstairs. Nothing. I found Oscar's headphones in his room, though. He never goes anywhere without these things.
I have looked upside down and backwards.
I mean, if they had gone somewhere, they would have left a note or something, for crying out loud.
Has anyone checked the cellar?
I'm not going down there.
They're not in the cellar, Beau. What? The cellar. No, I'm not going down there.
I'll check.
Thank you.
They'll be back in a couple days.
Maybe. In the meantime, we're left in the shit up to our necks.
Oscar's probably very happily surfing in Malibu.
Family saga.
Shut up.
You're not only locked in, but these fumes will consume you within the next hour.
I don't believe you. Shut up.
Goodbye. See you soon. The side of the river's
We gotta move fast.
We gotta find Bobo.
I know that.
Where the hell is he anyway?
Thank you.
It's gone. First Oscar and Donna. Now Eve. What's going on? I can't take it, Saint.
Okay, honey. I'm gonna get out of this house for good.
When?
Now.
What are we gonna do with Conrad?
We're gonna dump him.
No! We gotta put him back where we found him. Where he belongs.
Yeah, yeah. You're right. He belongs there. I owe him that.
Saint, I'm not going back there, man. No
Look.
Way.
Stu, don't give me a ton of shit. Just go upstairs and get the flashlights and let me worry about the details.
Same.
Look, just go! Either. Look, I know you're not gonna like this, but you're gonna have to help me take Conrad back to the cemetery.
I won't go near that place again.
Meg, come on.
And I'm not staying here either.
Meg.
I used to love this old house. I hate this house.
Honey.
The walls are so cold. Did you know that a woman committed suicide here once? Did you know that?
Yes, I did.
After me.
Hey, come on, honey. Come on, don't get crazy on me, okay? Meg, I love you. Everything's gonna be just fine, okay? All you've gotta do is just come with me and wait in the hearse. Come on, honey. Come on. Come on. Come on, honey. Come on. First, we gotta try and find Stu, okay? I hope to God nothing's happened to him. I'm gonna go look in the back. You look around the side of the house. Please, Meg, we are running out of time. It is gonna be light soon. Please.
Do you think that the dead can come back to life?
No, I don't.
We did something bad. I know someone is after me.
Get this number.
From Conrad.
Damn it! Look, I'm sorry, Meg, but time has run out. I need you with me. I need you with me. I don't have time for this nonsense anymore. Look, I am going to get the car, and you are going to go running upstairs, and you are going to pack your stuff, and you're going to do it now. You are going to go now. Go!
Imagination, but I didn't believe I had the guts.
Okay, Professor. I'm gonna check it out for you. But you gotta give me something more substantial to connect rats off. Something with your kids. I need something to work with. Do you understand me?
Maybe. Just a red carnation.
Frank, we're gonna need a search warrant from Judge Stewart. Get it the first thing in the morning.
Thank you.
bank.
Where is Saint Meg?
Where do you live, girl? Rugs of Saga, brought to you uninterrupted by commercials. I love a captive audience. Is it getting hot in here? A trifle stifling? Don't breathe in those fumes. They're really nasty.
Thank you.
I need these a lot more than you do, Conrad, my love. These are all the gifts you always promised but never gave me. I gave you everything. You won't need to tell time anymore, my sweet. And you thought you could take it with you.
Good evening, madame. Pity you missed your chance of watching the entire collection of Konrad Ragtsov horror films. But other pleasures await you. Come to me, my love. Not as bad as you think. It's actually quite pleasant. Maybe the food is a trifle overcooked and the champagne Californian, but you do meet the most interesting people. I hope in future you will show more respect for the dead.